Hi guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So I welcome you all in this session of Morning Tales for October 27, 2020. And those the students who are coming for the first time, I would like them to subscribe to this channel and hit the bell notification so that they can get the notifications about this channel and the new about the new uploads instantly. Also guys, you can join our Telegram group where we share free quizzes and also solve the queries of students. So here we will be starting the video with the first question itself. Which of the following company is the partner of Ministry of Culture in the Life and Miniature project? So recently Ministry of Culture has launched this Life and Miniature project. So let's discuss the answer of this question first, and then we will be discussing the details of this project. So the answer is Google. Option A, Google. Now, under this Life in Miniature project, what the ministry will do, under this project, the ministry is National Museum. So the National Museum, which is located in New Delhi, has partnered with Google Art and Culture app to display the miniature paintings of India which are there in this museum on this app. So this is the whole project all about, that is to display the miniature paintings which are there in the National Museum, which is under the Ministry of Culture, and the National Museum, which is located in New Delhi. So the miniature paintings which are there in this National Museum will be displayed on the apps of Google, on the app, art and cultural app of Google. Why is it being displayed? In order to promote India's culture. So this is the whole purpose of this project, life in miniature. So that's all that we should remember from the exam point of view. Now, my question for you is the minister of this Ministry of Culture. You will be telling me that in the comment section below. And I'm very glad with the response that I get from the students. The students tell me each and every answer, and I'm very glad at that. So bravo. And those who do not reply in the comment section, I would like them to reply so that you can remember answers better. Now let's discuss the second question. So who heads the Niti Aayog's Advisory Committee on Urban Planning Education System? First of all, what is the purpose of this committee? The committee has been made up in order to revise the whole education system of urban planning. And the committee will also look into the availability and the quality of urban planners present in India. So that is the whole purpose of this committee. And who heads this committee? It is Rajiv Kumar. So this Rajiv Kumar is also the vice chairman of Niti Aayog. Do remember this thing. And that is why he is very important. Rajiv Kumar has been appointed as the head of this committee on urban planning. Now, who is the CEO of this Niti Aayog? It is Amitabh Kant. So he is the CEO of Niti Aayog. Now you have to tell me the president. Who is the president of this Planning Commission of India? Do tell me your answer in the comment section below. And now let's move on to the third question. Where is the Assam Conservation Reserve located? First of all, let's answer this question, and then we will be discussing about the news from where this question has been put up. So the answer to this question is option B, Uttarakhand. The reserve is located in Garhwal region of Uttarakhand, and it is a wetland. So do remember this thing, that it is a wetland, and it is located in Uttarakhand's Garhwal region near Dehradun on the banks of Yamuna river. Now you would be thinking that why am I telling you all these details about this conservation reserve. The reason is that recently this conservation reserve has got the Ramsar site accreditation. So this site is Uttarakhand's first Ramsar site and India's 38th Ramsar site. So now India has 38 Ramsar sites. This number is very important, guys. Do remember this thing, that now India has 38 Ramsar site, and the latest site that has got this accreditation is Assam Conservation Reserve, which is in Uttarakhand. So these are the details about the news from where this question has been put up. Now we are talking about Ramsar site. So what is this Ramsar site? Let's discuss that. So basically, Ramsar site, so Ramsar convention is a treaty. So this Ramsar Convention on Wetlands is also known as Convention on Wetlands, signed in 1971 in Ramsar, Iran. India joined this convention in 1982, and the wetlands which are accredited as Ramsar sites are of international importance. So the burden of conserving those wetlands is higher. So the responsibility is higher. That is why these Ramsar site accreditation is very important for wetlands. So these are the facts about Ramsar sites. I hope that you will remember these facts because they are very important from the exam point of view. Now let's discuss the fourth question. Who has been elected as a chairperson of governing body of International Labour Organization? So recently, the chairperson has been elected, and it is after a break of 35 years that India has been appointed as the chairperson of this governing body of ILO. So who is that Indian? Who is that fortunate Indian that has got this opportunity? So he is Apoor Chandra. So he is a secretary of one of the Union Ministry of India. And which ministry? He is the secretary of which ministry? This is my question for you guys. You have to tell me in the comment section below. So that's all that we could discuss about this question. Now let's discuss the static facts about ILO. Not actually discuss. Let me ask you the questions regarding International Labour Organization. So for ILO, what are the four questions that you will be answering me? First is headquarters, second is members, third is the president, not president, director general. Because ILO does not have president, it's director general who is more important. So tell me the director general of ILO. And that's all. So tell me the answer of these three questions, and also who is the he is the secretary of which ministry? This question is also important, so do pay attention to this thing. And in case you find any kind of problem in answering these questions, do mention it in the comment section. I will tell you the answers myself. And here comes the last question. Who is the author of the Fixer Winning Has a Prize, How Much Will You Pay book? So this is a new book, and this is based on cricket. So this book is based on a cricketer whose name is Neil Upadhyay. So he was a very devoted cricketer, but unfortunately he got meddled into match fixing, and that is why his career was ruined. And this book is based on his life. And now you have to tell me who is the author of this book. So the answer is option B. It's Suman Dubey. She is the author of this book, and the cover page looks like this. So I hope that this cover page helps you in memorizing the book and the author here. And here this session ends, and I hope that you have really liked this session. Do mention your answers in the comment section below about the questions that I have asked you. Thank you so much for watching this session. Do come back tomorrow at the same time at 7 o'clock, and do watch this session regularly for your phase 1 preparation of SEBI, RBI and NABARD exams. Thank you.